What is undetectable AI content? Why do you need it? And how can you publish it on your website so your website stays human-like, sounds non-robotic, and pleases Google? Let's discuss in this video. So first of all, undetectable AI content is the phrase used whenever we're talking about content built or generated with AI that doesn't read like a robot wrote it, AKA it can't be detected as AI. That's undetectable AI content. Now, when it comes to why you need this, first of all, for two reasons. Number one, sounding like a robot is a bad thing no matter how you put it. People, specifically consumers, don't want to buy from a robot. They want to buy from a real person. And so if the content you put out there sounds robotic in general, you're doing your brand a disservice. You're in the category of spam and straight up crappy content. Instead, you want to be in the category of engaging, informative, entertaining, educational content, because that is what draws people in. Secondly, Google has a lot of things to say about spammy content, including the use of generative AI, if spam is the primary purpose of that content. In March of 2024, Google rolled out a new core update that is set to hit 40% of spam on the web. That's millions and millions of pages. It's the biggest update to hit spam that's ever been launched by Google. And it's penalizing sites with garbage, robotic, spammy, boring, misleading, outdated, fluffy content left and right. That kind of content isn't standing in the wake of this huge update Google made to improve the quality of search. Their whole goal when launching this update was to show less content that feels like it was made to attract clicks and to show more content that people find useful. This brings us right back to our topic today, undetectable AI content. Publishing content that doesn't read robotic is important not just to satisfy SEO, but again, to actually get your readers to click on your stuff, buy from you, and take the next step. And that should ultimately be your goal with content, even SEO content, is to drive revenue. If you're using ChatGPT, even the latest model, GPT-4 Turbo, you're going to get two things, and this often happens with Gemini, Claude, Mistral, and other models as well. The first one is a cutoff date. Now, GPT-4 Turbo has a cutoff date of April of 2023, but if you actually ask ChatGPT, which I have, when's your cutoff date, it will tell you December of 2023. This means you're not getting breaking news. And because of AI and the rapid advance of technology right now, that's not a good thing. We literally have a huge breaking news headline every 5 days, sometimes every 24 hours. The second thing you're gonna deal with are hallucinations. This is when the AI just basically makes up random shit that's not facts for the sake of generating content. And these two errors are just as bad as detectable robotic AI content, because they mean that you're not gonna have current facts to share with your readers, and the AI is prone to a complete lack of truth and anything grounded in facts because of the problem of hallucinations. If you want to use ChatGPT to blog, the best way to do it is to enable a plugin. You could also do this through the GPT store. In Explore GPTs, I've typed in Web Pilot. I'm going to click Start Chat. And then from here, I can actually prompt ChatGPT to create a blog with real-time data. And here's how you want to do that. Once you have a keyword, for the purpose of this video, we're going to use the keyword, what is content marketing? You want to put that keyword into Google and see what's actually ranking at the top of Google. From the top three results, try to pick the best one, the one that reads the best, gets straight to the point, doesn't have fluff. So spend some time looking through those top three results to pick your favorite. With the Web Pilot Custom GPT, tell it to read the following URL. Enable web crawling. ChatGPT will talk to the web through this plugin and it will start to generate facts. Head nod here to Matt Diggity. I'm using his super prompt from his YouTube video. And that super prompt is this. I give it that URL from the top three of Google with the best content. And then I'm telling ChatGPT and the Web Pilot Custom GPT, analyze and gather all the facts found in this document. When producing content that requires facts found in this document, you will strictly use the document's facts rather than the facts found in your training data. Like Diggity says, that piece, you will strictly use the document's facts, is important so that you point ChatGPT to current facts and avoid hallucinations or that data cutoff. And so you can see it's gathering all of the facts. We want to verify these facts, put them into Google, and make sure that these are accurate. And they are, they've checked out. So from here, we can actually put together the blog post. And here's what that would look like. you want to have ChatGPT write it section by section. Now, I'm going to warn you, this is going to be quite a process because you have to make it undetectable. And here's what that can look like: an endless loop of struggle. And yes, I have a solution for you, so stay with me. You're going to learn about an undetectable AI writer that solves this problem. But here's the problem you run into when using a single LLM that simply generates content based on a pattern, predicting what the next word string should be. So we're going to take this, copy and paste it into Originality, one of the leading AI detection scanners. It's coming out 100% AI, which is not good. So we're going to prompt ChatGPT to rewrite it to be undetectable. And then we're going to take that next paragraph and run it through the same checker. But here's the problem. It's 100% AI still. At this point, I would probably try to switch to another LLM if I wanted to proceed with this tedious task of generating undetectable content myself. And I would switch to Gemini or Claude with the same process. Run your content through an AI detector, see if it comes back, scoring as robotic, and just keep rewriting it until it's there. And remember, AI detectors are good at one thing. They're detecting how robotic that content sounds. They're not foolproof. I ran a completely 100% humanly written article through originality.ai as of recording this video, and it gave me a 59% AI result. So it's telling me that this is more likely to be AI than a human, even though I know for a fact that this article was written by a human. In fact, it's from my archives. I sold content as a service for 10 years in a writing agency that I built up to around 100 writers. And I copy and pasted a specific piece of content from a humanly written article. This was before ChatGPT came out, years before. But we have an AI detector saying that this is 60% likely to be AI generated. And the reason for that is it's detecting how robotic this content sounds. So unfortunately, this human writer has a bad habit of writing like a robot. All in all, AI detection is a good thing because I think it's encouraging us to be better writers overall, whether that's a human writing that content or even an AI. In the end, like I said earlier, people and consumers buy from people they trust. Content that reads robotically is not going to build any trust with your audience base and especially your customers. So this is a good problem to solve. And I think it's a good thing that AI detectors are bringing it to the awareness of the public. But you have to remember these things aren't foolproof. And that's what I want to show you with this scan of humanly generated content where a human writer wrote every word, but it's still scored as 59% AI. You have to take these things with a grain of salt. Okay, so we could be in an endless loop of hell here, trying to make our content undetectable on our own. Or we could actually use an undetectable AI SEO writer that specializes in generating content that passes detection and most importantly reads like a human wrote it. Recently, 8xing the traffic on contenthacker.com, we were at 4,000 some odd unique visitors a year ago, and now we're almost at 40,000 per month. We've published around 380 blogs on this site, and the majority of them were generated with RankWell by Content at Scale. RankWell is so easy. Once you set up your project, aka your website, you can simply write a post straight from a keyword, an existing URL, a YouTube video, a podcast episode, an audio file, a raw doc. I recommend generating content from a keyword, especially if you have that informational intent, high traffic keyword. That is a goldmine. So you just drop the keyword in and you click write post now. That's it. No further prompting, no back and forth with an AI detector a bajillion times. And you get, for example, on this post generated for the keyword, how to write a novel, 2,400 words of scroll worthy, good content. We've simply inserted a few images, screenshots, added in some links to our other posts, and that's it. It's ready to go. On average, this saves me 7 hours out of an 8-hour long-form SEO blog writing process. And from the in-app editor inside of RankWell, I can even do a plagiarism scan to see how original this content is. For example, for this one in particular, it's telling me that it's hard to tell, and I need to go through and update and rewrite a few sentences. Here's another post straight out of the system without any editing that passed as human, with the majority of the content reading completely human-like. meaning I don't have to do any work to take this into the undetectable AI content zone. And even when it's hard to tell, it just takes a few tweaks of those sentences to take it into the green zone. This in-app editor also directly corresponds to my WordPress site. In the project settings, I can download the WordPress plugin and then upload that to my site. And straight from here, I can take it into the correct status for the post. If I'm ready to publish, I can hit publish and it'll go live on my site. When it's time to publish undetectable AI content, I recommend you match up a tool like RankWell, Content Scales, SEO, AI Writer, with that goal, because then you actually save time and you can even save money versus hiring a human or even putting your time on making sure all of that content reads like a human wrote it, which is really the secret sauce of RankWell. RankWell has its own proprietary tool stack built in with SEO tools like keyword research, optimization audits, topic reports, and real-time SERP analysis that goes into every single post generated. It's also built with multiple LLMs, which means it's not relying on a single LLM to produce crappy, fluffy, shitty content that could have hallucinations and incorrect facts. With the deep research update that we launched in March of 2024, the Content Scale RankWell content now generates a custom database of real-time research for every single blog post, pulling from breaking news and influencer or expert quotes on social media to add to that article. That takes it beyond the undetectable AI content zone and far into the valuable educational zone. For more tips on how to generate amazing content with AI that builds your brand, be sure to subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you right here on the next video.